No need to ask where I'm from, you already know. I represent the A from my head to my toes. Step on the dance floor.
What's up, you guys? It is me once again, and today I'm also in a rush. I'm always in a rush, but I'm gonna try to get a video out every single day, hopefully. Like I said, I'm taking advantage of my full time. Real quick, shout out to my hubby, just because if it wasn't for him, I would not be doing this full time. So get you one, not mine, but get you one, okay? Anyways, we're gonna go ahead and move right into the tutorial. Okay guys, so today's video is gonna be more of a talk through, but I'm still gonna make it speedy. So I'm gonna start off with the Renew Intense Skin Therapy by Minidoka. This is Balm AF. It's good for eczema, any skin, anything. I still wanna use a little primer, NYX Skin Veil. I'm just gonna take that. Take a dab and keep it moving. Okay, and for foundation, I'm gonna be using the LA Colors Truly Matte in shade. No. By the way, this foundation is bomb, diggity bomb, diggity bomb. Like, it is truly matte. But it really does hold up. It's full coverage, like it does not play. You can build it up pretty nicely, and it has an eye shade range. What I really like about it though, bitch, I mean to call you bitch, is $6, $4, $5, $3. I don't know, around there is it's that. So just know I was gonna do everything like affordable drugstore-ish, but I'll say right now I have not found anything better than this. Nothing, never, nada. Like, just the way it performs, just everything about it, I could marry it, to be honest. If I wasn't already married and it wasn't illegal, I would do it. Okay, I got my sponge, and this is by Equal Tools. Y'all, it's soft, and it does the thing. The damn thing, it does it. That's what this does. And I'm just gonna blend, and I like to blend out the outer edges first. Okay, so anyways, about this concealer, it has a lot of product. I bought this, I can't remember how long ago. It is like Superman in a bottle. Yeah, I've been enjoying the Maybelline Fit Me Loose Powder. Looks like this. Looks like that. All right, bit set, let's go. Next, I'm gonna be using the Contour and Blush 2 by Beach Cosmetics. Yo, I've been using this for I don't know how long. Hello there. And I fucking love this. I fucking love you, bro. It's like this. And I just find that it works on all skin types. Skin tones. I'm gonna grab a bigger brush. Let me just grab like a flat. An angled blush brush, but it's gonna be for contour. It just has the perfect, absolute, most perfect angle. Okay. Now I'm gonna grab that brush that I had initially grabbed, which was too small, but it's perfect for the dark contour. And I'm just gonna keep this in a little bit more in that actual hollow. And I always ask my clients to smile, because you know, you can see where it's at, and blend that in the hollow and then up. And I'm gonna do the exact same side, exact same thing on the other side. So you can just watch me doing this side. So we can keep it moving, and then, you know, do it on yourself, okay? And so this is the, I'm gonna mix these two. I usually go with this, just it's on its own. But I don't really know what I'm gonna do for the eyes yet. I'm winging it, y'all. Please pray for me. Anywho, I changed my mind. So I decided I went, I initially went with the red, then the black, then the gray, then the white, and then the yellow was just like the, that it needed, you know? So I'm gonna take this one and that one. I don't know, I like the mix of them two together. I feel like they perform a lot better. And I'm just gonna apply this right in there. I am gonna go with the similar color scheme that I tried to do last time. You guys saw what happened on my Instagram. If you don't follow me on Instagram, follow me on Instagram. I'm gonna go with the red shade now. Okay, so just blend that color halfway in the purple and halfway out. So, and just now you always, well, I always have to go back in with like the previous shade just to retouch it up and blend it into it some more. And as you can see, it gave me a nice even, it gave me a nice even blend. So boom boom pow. Now I'm gonna go in with a yellow, the yellow color, and slowly but surely blend. I like to take little by little and work my way around the blend, if that makes sense. Because if you're just kind of like, you kind of sometimes lose track of what you're, where you're going. That doesn't even make sense, but if you do makeup, it does make sense. And deepen up that plum tone. Let me tell you guys something. When it comes to purples, plums, colors like these, and reds as well, like when you're trying to make a gradient and you don't want to really use like black, you use brown. Okay, I'm just saying, I've been an artist for quite some time. That's just how it's always worked. So if you want to intensify your plummy colors like this, use that brown. And you see it's like Anastasia Beverly Hills brushes. I really love their this side for packing on color. And I'm going in with that black, and I'm going to pack that in the inner corner, not going past that brown. Doing the same thing for the outer corner. And I didn't really, hold on, let me not speak too soon. Hold on guys, there's no fallout. I mean, you tell me, what do you see? And make sure that all those purples are blended nicely into the black. And that's it for that. I'm gonna cut the crease right in the middle and I'll be right back. Sorry you guys, I know you probably wanted to see how I cut my crease, but I will make a super detailed video on that separately because it's a whole nother business. What am I gonna grab? Okay, I'm gonna go back in with that same brush, and this is where we're gonna get a little detailed here. That any one of those plummy colors, to be honest, I stay like, ever since I got this palette, I just mix them. And we're gonna place that right between the black and right between, you know, like just cover that edge and then blend it outwards. Not outwards, but inwards. Very, like, literally nothing. Keep it mostly there. And I achieve this by using a tapping motion instead of, like, I'm pretty much still just working with it. But now, I'm gonna go ahead and just jump straight into the silver shade, y'all. Watch this, okay? I'm not even gonna say nothing. I'm not gonna say shit. Watch this. Is y'all there still? Like, oh. The same before my camera cut off. Yeah, I packed on that silver. And don't worry if it's a little messy, because you're gonna be working back and forth with that red and that silver. So again, here's that silver, I mean the red, and it's really quite easy to blend these in. So yeah, just work with it, girl. So after you've gotten to somewhere where you're like true, then you can just go ahead and finish your lower lash line off. You guys see how I kind of like me pasé aquí a little bit? Well, it's okay because I still have to do like red. So just lay that red right over top. Either way, we already have that darkness from the plum. And finish the outer shape of your eye look. So yeah, the yellow's still gonna go outside of that. Y'all, this is like everyday to me, but I'm a dramatic bitch, okay? Understand this now. Use patting motions to carefully place this on here. And it might look a little bit like, I guess just not blending right now, but like place your color down first and then blend it, honey. Don't argue with me. If you guys don't have like a liner or something where you want to like line your waterline, try this. Of course, clean your brush or whatever. Just dip into it and you'll get like a little bit on it of that green color. And you're pretty much slowly but surely you can build it up. Just be careful. I'm not condoning this, but this is what I sometimes do when I just don't have a liner that I really, really want in the waterline. Okay, and today I'm gonna use my Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. And to be honest, I love you, Too Faced, but this mascara is not better than sex. At least not my. Oh, TMI. I have my little cousin watching this. I'm sorry. Okay, so I popped on my lashes, and now that my eyes are done, which. Let me bring. Oh my. Okay, y'all saw what happened. I got foundation, no concealer in my hair, but whatever. This is the eye look. I'm gonna pop on some a little lipstick, a little highlight, and we is done. And I'm using Vintage Rose by Gerard Cosmetics today, and I'm just literally gonna nothing it today. It ain't really nothing on there. I just kind of don't want my lips to look so sickly. And I'm gonna use a gloss by Victoria's Secret, and this is Beauty Rush flavored gloss. You know what it is. You know what it is. And pop that right in the center. I'm gonna grab another fluffy brush, going with the Fenty Beauty Hustle Baby. And y'all, watch this. I'm trying to get like a good view on the glow. Y'all, oh my gosh. Well, fuck, I can't tell y'all. Y'all will know in due time. But just gonna have to wait. And that's what we doing. And I like to smile to really, mira, puedes Valeria, fíjate lo que estás haciendo, chingón. Like to get a good view of my cheekbones by smiling, okay? Smiling, it doesn't hurt no one, okay? And literally just do it at the very top of your cheekbones. You can't miss it. Can go wrong. Smile, okay? Is that it, girl? That's it. Oh my gosh, we did it again. This is the final look. I will do. I have so many coming. Like, y'all have no idea. I just really appreciate the support, the love. Y'all real as fuck. Like, I just don't understand how people can't support each other. Like, because I don't, luckily, thankfully, I'm not going through that. Like, all my friends are so ride or die. All of my, everybody, I love y'all. Anyways, stay tuned for the next video. And I hope y'all like this. If y'all recreate this, tag me in it. And I want to see how y'all do. Okay, anyways, I think that's it. Let me know if y'all feel this. Like, subscribe, all that good jazz. And I'll see y'all in my next video. Bye.